Governor Ehrlich is at the vanguard of making the GOP relevant in Maryland. I got my start in statewide GOP politics when he asked me to serve as state party counsel shortly after his election in 2002. I'm not alone among today's state party leaders who were active in the Ehrlich administration. Governor Hogan and delegate soon-to-be Senator Mary Beth Carrozza also played significant roles in the Ehrlich administration. I'm grateful that Governor Ehrlich continues to play a prominent role in today's state Republican Party and congratulate him on receiving this well-deserved honor.
So I met Bob Ehrlich when he was a young, dashing, handsome man, when Al Bullock was still alive. And one day he called me at the White House and he wanted a tour for someone that he wanted me to meet. And that night he brought his parents and a beautiful young lady. She was the best one we had met yet. And her name was Kendall. And we had a wonderful evening tour. He called me the next day and to thank me for the tour. And I told him then, if he didn't marry that girl, he was a fool. And obviously he wasn't a fool because they have been married ever since. Thank you, Governor, for 30 years of public service. You've been absolutely wonderful for the state of Maryland.
Hello, my name is Joe Shano, and I'm going to tell you about the first election I could vote in. It was 2002, and I was a senior at Stephen Decatur High School, and Bob Ehrlich was running for governor here in Maryland. Bob's message of less fees, less regulation, and smaller, smarter government inspired me. I worked with the local Republican Party to try and get Bob elected. I knocked on doors, I waved signs, anything I could do to get Bob across the finish line, and we won. I was caught up in the hope and optimism that Bob's election win gave the rest of the state. In 2014, I did the same for Governor Hogan. I worked on the shore to make sure that Governor Hogan won the state. His message of hope, smaller and smarter government, and less regulation has inspired me to run for House of Delegates here in 38C. I want to continue both Bob and Governor Hogan's legacy of less regulation, smaller, smarter government, and bring common sense to Annapolis.
I want to thank the Montgomery County Republican Party for honoring Governor Robert Ehrlich for his more than 30 years of public service to the residents of Maryland. Bob Ehrlich was a good friend of my father's when they served together in the House of Delegates. My dad had great respect for Governor Ehrlich, and of course so do I. I remember my dad being so proud when Governor Ehrlich was elected in 2002. It was one of the happiest days of his life. And I remember the time he told me about how he got to go upstairs and sit in the governor's chair. He was so proud of Governor Ehrlich for all that he had accomplished, and I am as well. I was fortunate enough to be able to serve 2 years in the Maryland State Senate while Governor Ehrlich was in office, and had a great relationship with him. He did so many great things for the residents of Maryland, focused so much on education and other issues that are so important to people in Maryland. And I just can tell you that he and his wife Kendall have really sacrificed a lot for us in Maryland and really gave a lot to all of us. And I really want to thank both of them. Because you know, Governor Ehrlich, just like my wife is my greatest asset, Kendall's one of your greatest assets as well, and I know she has sacrificed a lot as well. So I want to congratulate both Governor Bob Ehrlich and Kendall for your many years of service to Maryland.
Delegate Tony McConkie, to one of my favorite constituents, thank you, Governor Ehrlich, for 30 years of service. Thank you so much.
In 2002, I voted for Governor Ehrlich, but I had no idea who he was. He was just a Republican name on the ballot. 4 years later, I was just beginning to get involved in local politics, and his campaign was the first one that I worked on. It was so much fun. It was exciting. I don't even remember if I actually got to meet him that cycle. I was just a lowly volunteer, and he was, oh my gosh, he was the governor. Unfortunately, the election didn't go the way that we wanted, but we all persevered. In 2010, I was asked to serve as a county coordinator for his campaign, and this is when I truly began to see what an amazing person he is. He is a tireless campaigner and a caring and compassionate person. I loved watching him speak with Marylanders across the state, listening to their concerns. Unfortunately, the voters still didn't get it right, but I had begun a great friendship. Later, when I ran for party leadership, both he and Kendall were very supportive and encouraged me to run. I always knew I could count on him for anything that I needed. When I was elected state party chairman, he called to congratulate me and to make sure that I knew that if I ever needed his help, he was there for me and for the party. and he's still a great friend of the party. My favorite memory of Bob is the day I played chauffeur for him. He was speaking at a Lincoln Day dinner per my request and needed a driver, so I volunteered. I had the absolute best time of my life. He is so funny. He had me in tears multiple times, and a couple times I almost had to pull over. I was laughing so hard. Bob Ehrlich is the full package. A loving husband, a devoted father, handsome, funny, smart, and a dedicated public servant. Thank you, Governor Ehrlich, for your many years of service. And personally speaking, thank you for your friendship, your love, and your support. You're the best.
Hi, I'm Al Mendelson, chair of the Baltimore County Republican Party. I'm here in the state capitol reflecting on my 30-year relationship with Bob Ehrlich. Together, we were volunteers, candidates, and friends. Bob served as a delegate, congressman, and governor. But to me, he will always be a friend and a party builder. When he arrived in Annapolis in January of 1987, there were 17 Republicans in the House of Delegates. Today, that number is 50. Bob, you've been a great party builder and a great friend, and we encourage you to keep doing what you've been doing.
Hello, this is Nicolie Ambrose, Maryland's National Committeewoman. Today I want to talk about Governor Bob Ehrlich. And I have to tell you, I think he did one thing for us in particular. He taught us how to win as Republicans in Maryland. Way back when Bob was our great congressman and I restarted the Baltimore area Young Republicans, Bob would be there. He'd show up and he'd say, just come out and work with me and we will win. And he did, over and over again, until he was elected the first Republican governor in a generation. So Bob, thank you for proving to us that if we just work hard enough and are smart about it, we can win.
Hey, Gov, it's your old friend Larry Hogan. I just wanted to say that I'm so proud to have served in your administration, and we've been friends a long time. I can tell you that I wouldn't be governor without you being governor first. I was honored to know you as a friend, honored to be a part of your administration. Just want to thank you for everything you've done for the state of Maryland and for all of us.